Hi there, Wendy Green here, video 7, and just I think it's just going to be a short one because I am getting a little bit tired, but there's something I want to put in into this little talk here on May 2nd, which is a 2/7/12 day. And in the previous video, video 6, I talked about the choices and what you have to do. And as always, you know, I follow the numbers. The information is always the building up from 1 to 9, so to speak, that follows the principles, that follows the rotundum, that follows the creational numbers, that follows the highest level, the next level, the third level, and all of these kind of things that goes with knowledge, choices, dynamics of evolution and all of these very, very complex things that for most of you that have not studied my material, that have not read the philosophy book, whole philosophy book, it does not make sense whatsoever. So this is a complex study. This is not just something you just jump into and then you have all the answers. This is a progression journey, first and foremost. So, but with all progression journeys, this is kind of, I know many of you will say, what would you have me to do then? What would you recommend? What do you think I should do? Because that's what many of you do. You ask me, what should I do? Should I move? Should I stay? Is this a safe place to be? Should I sell my house? Should I go into a bunker? Should I kill myself? I can't recommend that. But people are asking me this, and when I say, well, it appears that that country is going to fall under the dark forces, then people ask me, should I move? Should I leave? And I say, well, what do you feel like doing? This is not me giving you the answers. I'm not your go-to person. I'm not the one that sits with the answers. I'm the one that sits with the understanding of the implications. But what is the right choice for you? And that's what it comes down to. Because what is progression? What is the original dynamic of the original races? It is to master energy and consciousness. And do you master consciousness and energy if you go to your teacher and ask your teacher for answers? I'm not your parent. I'm not your girlfriend. I'm not your boyfriend. I'm not your lover. I'm not your anything where you go and ask how to do. I'm not your mom. And I'm not your therapist. And I'm not these kind of things. And you know the dynamics. And to do the Zen Buddhism where the student come and ask the teacher, and it's all about your cup is completely full of predispositions of ideas and concepts and whatever, and you already made your idea of reality. And the only reason why you're asking me, because you are in doubt. And what is that doubt about? Why do you doubt? Why don't you know clearly what to do? What is fighting in you so that you don't just have the answer ready? And I actually talk about that in the Freeman material in the whole advanced classes. I think it's in whole advanced class 3 where I talk about the choices, the paths that are shown to you, the left or the right. Are you going to go up or down or whatever's going to happen? What direction are you to take? And that is for you to figure out. So when it comes with choice making, it is about that you get all of the implications laid out for you. This is when you're a child, it's just, am I going to do a black lollipop or a red lollipop? So that's the simple one. That's for the immature. It's that simple, and you have a parent and they tell you what to do, and that's good and fine. And these are the children, and that's portion of humanity that will remain there. But for those of us who are going to do the transition, we don't want children to do the transition. We want mature, grown-up beings that have lived their lives, experienced what they are dealing with, understanding that this takes scientific understanding. This takes maturity. This takes a complete understanding of the sciences, of the original worlds, of the future worlds, and what we are dealing with. This takes knowledge. This takes maturity. And this takes the ability to take a stand, to stand erect in your own circle of what you have created and understand what you have created and let go of what is not functional anymore and what you can't use compared to the global settings you're actually in a dynamic interaction with. So when we talk about this, the planetary grid and that seclusion that was there, even though it was taken over and turned to ill and all these kind of things, the origin of it was to ensure that you would do this slow gradient maturing so that you would come to terms with things in a pace that would not be too frightening, because we know fear does not really do anything for you other than pull you down into your fight and flight, limbic, instinctual, third cycle type of predatorious type of energy. Energies where you will respond in irrational ways that are not productive for anyone, because if you take that one into the fourth dimension, you will create havoc on a level that is beyond your comprehension. So we can't have that. So there are a lot of stuff that's going to happen in the next 100 years that will take that into consideration, different programs that will ensure that humanity matures as quickly as possible within a controlled rate where fear will not take over. And that is where the counterforces, of course, will come in with the opposite plan, so they can take over in that gradient, slowly progression that is happening on our planet. But what do you need to do? What can I advise you to do? Because I'm not going to tell you what to do. If you ask me, am I going to leave America? Am I going to move to Europe? Or am I going to leave Australia? Am I going to Europe? And where am I going to go to Europe? And which country do I need to move to? And what do I need to do? Do I need to go to Iceland? Do I move to Australia, the opposite? Or do you move to, or do I live in or Europe? Do I need to go to America? And where do I need to settle? And if I'm in America, which city should I live in? What state? And all of these questions. And there are absolutely no clear-cut questions here. There are no parents for you anymore. There are no go-tos. And the planetary hierarchy are definitely not going to give you the answer either, because it's very clear in the Mailer material. The hierarchy will come up with the plan for the next 100 years. They will put it in motion through the normal channels that they have to put this in motion. And then the hierarchy will turn away so that they will let things happen as they're supposed to in their normal evolutionary rate. Because if the planetary hierarchy focus on the solutions they have chosen, then they will amplify them in a way similar to what we saw with the celestial angel beings. If they came into our planet or into our reality, they would blast everything like a meteor. So the hierarchy cannot focus their intention or their energies onto humanity, as it also is described very clearly in the Bailey material. They have worked through different channels, different groups, and they have tried to internalize and externalize the hierarchy and all the things that they were supposed to do. And we can ask whether or not these methods that were supposed to happen the last 100 years, if they are at all can be used now, considering what we have got of alien, other dimensional, all parallel system entities here, which were not here 100 years ago when they made the Bailey material. So that's kind of a new factor that has come in. But what I'm saying here is that you can't wait for the hierarchy to make the decisions and then you will get the newsletter of this is what you need to do, because there's no progression in that, is there? If you are asked to make a choice, if you are being told what choice to make, will you then progress at all? No, you'll just do flock mentality. You'll just do as you are told and you will not ask the critical questions. You will not feel inside whether or not this resonates with you. You will not choose your own path. You will be given a path. That's not initiation. That's not progression. That's not development. That's not regaining your consciousness structure. You need to ask questions and you need to be critical, scientifically critical, not emotionally critical, that is based upon gut feeling, but scientific knowledge of what you're dealing with and what you are to investigate and what you are to come up with solutions. And there is never one solution, because the more you know what you do not know, and the more you do not know, the more you have to figure out, and the more you figure out, the more you know what you do not know, and the more you have to figure out. That's the process. That's the learning process. So that's the knowledge. So, and going back to the whole kind of our logos and what was the love and what kind of love. The love was technically to give a second chance for the ones that succumbed to both the LPU or to the timeline event or whatever. That was the goodness that was created for this as a transformational system. So portion of this is also to get your knowledge back of how to transform the energies to reach the balance point from where you can choose to go upwards or you can choose to go downwards. Turn dark or turn light, that's all up to you. You have a multiple of choices, and each and one of these choices lead to a learning process from where you most likely will fail. But through the failures, which are small crises, you will learn a lesson. You will learn energy. You will learn how to handle whatever has come your way. And you will either mature by it because you are working with it in a correct way and evaluate and learn from it and make better strategies, or you will completely fail and fall apart and go into victimization and self-pity and do the regression spiral and become depressive and all sorts of other psychological structures. So that's all up to you, how you are mentalizing whatever's coming your way. Are you surviving this or are you going to succumb to it? So that's the first part of the choices of what is coming in the future. The other one is the ability to make triage, as in kind of what is around you and what you need to do and what's most important now. What can wait until tomorrow? What can't wait until tomorrow? What do you need to work with today? And what will tomorrow bring, so that you are in a constant state of flux, constant state of being able to handle chaos, constant state of it being able to transform what comes your way into something productive that becomes a learning lesson instead of being a victimization lesson. Doing whatever you can do with your energy work, your physicality, live the right way. You already got that. It's already put out there. Nobody needs to tell you that one. Plant fruitarian, no alcohol, no drugs, no smoking, no sugar, no all. It's all already out there. When I say no sugar, I mean refined sugar, candy, bullshit stuff that makes you fat and complacent and creates havoc in your system because it changes your glucose level and fattening your liver and doing all sorts of very bad stuff to with you, so your liver cannot clear the blood in the right way, and that affects your heart and then clogs your veins and all of these kind of things. So all of these, you know, all of this, it's already out there. You don't need me to tell you that one. It's all over the internet. That's common knowledge. You can always discuss what is healthy food and what is not healthy food, but being a plant fruitarian is definitely for sure. And I've already in my books, both in The Souls of Humanity, in Tarology, and in my material, including the free material, told you that what is the right plant food for you, what's the right fruit, fruitarian food for you, will all depend on how your system is built, what kind of pH value that you have, which kind of electrochemical systems you have, that goes with what we call the rays, that goes with the composition of your different fields. So what is healthy for one person is not necessarily healthy for one. One can eat spinach, another one cannot eat spinach, so spinach is not necessarily a superfood. Someone can eat kales, others cannot eat kales. Someone loves bananas, others cannot ingest bananas and break down the sugar in bananas and all of these kind of things. So it's not just oh yeah, all bananas are healthy or all kale are healthy or whatever. You need to discover your own individual biofield and how it works and how you are strengthening and amplifying the protein and enzymes and the different ways that your body function, and that goes with the solar plexus and that goes with the whole intestine system, everything you ingest, including your emotional response to what comes your way and your mental response to what comes your way. So these, all of these I've explained in my material, and that's why I took the time to make it. And I could clearly and easily make a new version of it in some way and some form, and I might not, I don't know. But all of the material that's out there now, both in free material as well as in my classes, it's extremely valid. I go through all of the hoops and the loops of what it means to go through this process. And there are still a lot of things that are unanswered, because you simply cannot cover all of the bases of the individuality of all of the fields and energy systems that are around this planet and are in humans, because we are not identical. None of us are identical. There are always little differences that tweaks things a little bit. So this is why you need to take it into your own hand. Nobody can give you the answer. Nobody can give you the answers. Only you. And that's the process that begins. But there are two steps in, first and foremost, understanding this one. Stop giving your power away. Stop looking outside for answers. Now you turn internally, you go inside, you learn to find the answer, you learn to listen to your body, you learn to follow your intuition, you learn to work with your emotional field, you learn to work with your mental field. That's the first basic baby steps. That's the maturing process. So you don't sit like a child, mom, can I get this? And you take it into your own hand and rise up and become a grown-up and be a good parent to yourself and nurture yourself, take care of yourself and get that emotional balance you need, so you're not in some constant strife with yourself, constant doubt with yourself, constant not knowing what to do, constantly being possessed by snakes because you're opening up to this in all your doubt processes and in all of your emotional responses and all of your emotional comfort zones and belief systems and whatever that's going on, that is not going to work in your favor. On the contrary, because they're not made to work in your favor. So that's the first step you need to understand. And the Baylor material concurs with that, because they literally calls us the prisoners of this planet for good reasons. And it also said that the Logos that created this planet, he divided the cosmic evil amongst the different kingdoms. So there you got that one as well. We're all here to transform stuff. We're not here to enjoy this planet. It's made very beautiful, but that is just kind of so it wasn't sore on the eyes as well, because that would not really do the whole kind of transforming things into beauty, right? You need to have beauty to know what beauty is. But that does not mean that the plants is done with their processes of evolution. On the contrary, I'm working tremendously with my plants, trying to shift them into fourth dimension. I'm working with my house to transform it into fourth dimension. I'm working with my body to transform it into fourth dimension. I'm working my emotional field and my mental field. I'm working with my lamp, I'm working with my clothes, I'm working with my computer, I'm working with my fridge, I'm working with everything I am surrounded knowing. All of this needs to be able to somehow, somewhere do the transition into fourth dimension. My cup, my computer mouse, my pen, it doesn't matter, my socks, my underwear, everything is imbued with energy that is part of this planet that will do the transition. So we must work on all levels. My books, the physical forms, what can be tossed, what can be used, what is the rightful use of it? What is the right resourceful use of this? How can we ensure that this is not working on third cycle energies? Can I transform my computer? Still runs on the L grid, the electric grid, but can I transform it into also holding fourth dimensional energies? Can I put in symbols that are similar to the symbols of energy we're going to use on Mars? Can I already begin to implement that one into my computer? These are some of the experiments I'm doing. So your whole life is going to be one great science lab where you have questions and answers, you ask yourself and you find the answers yourself, where you're working scientifically with energy and your consciousness. How much are you going to put in of your consciousness in things so you make sure you don't get completely linked up to it and become transhuman? Can you work with things without becoming transhuman? Can you do it as a kind of transition modality? Transhumanism is stuck in the crystalline structures, whereas the modality of progression are transformable and flexible and in constant flux. Can you change your emotional field to be able to do that flux all the time? And these are the things that you are to aim for. But the first step to all begin in any form of anything is that you need to kind of have a foundational belief in what is to come. And this is where you feel you resonate with. What do you resonate with? What do you actually think? Sit down and think, what do you see for the future? What are you seeing of implications? What are you seeing out there? Where do you think things need to go? And don't do it from an emotional standpoint, because that will just be either, oh, it's horrible or whatever. You can't do emotional assessment. It has to be logical, rational. See the things that are there, see the signs, look into what's going on, listen to different people saying different things and whatever's going on, or listen to me and feel if that's something you can say, well, that kind of resonates, that kind of, I know that's true. And that's the first step, that you get to this point where you're not in doubt and not discussing with yourself and not discussing with others and not making little groups where you discuss my material and is she right or is she wrong, and you're sitting there and you're discussing back and forth and creating thought forms and emotional responses and completely fucking everything up by your own fears and your own belief systems and your own comfort zone. No, this has to be done from an extremely clear standpoint of knowledge. And you will only get that when your mental field is working, where it's controlling the emotional field, where the emotional field is cleared, and where you have control over your physicality. And that's the chakra system you have to have nailed. As long as your chakra system is dysfunctional and it is polluted by the different fragmented regressive genetics, then you will not really get any viable answers. You will might feel, oh, I might feel this and that, whatever. That's not a clear answer. Clear knowledge comes as a complete alignment, where it's like you get a steel cord inside of you. I know this. No questions, no answers, no nothing. I know this. And then you look out through your ajna chakra, and then you see, I know this, and then you get level of information that comes to you. That's the right answer. And it goes with polarity. So it's not a right answer of good stuff. It's a right answer of next step of your scientific journey of progression. So that's the first step. You need to kind of have where you think this is all going. And once you know this, you make choices. And then you put these choices into motion. Then you put these choices into action. Then you implement these choices in your life. And you don't do it over 5 fucking years. You do it now. You do it this week. You change it right away. So that's the first step. That's all I can say to you that you need. When you ask me, what am I to do? This is what you are to do. Don't rely on me for your answers, because you won't learn a damn thing. Learn to rely on your own answers, because the whole asking others for answers, because you're afraid of what you might come up with. So see your fears. Acknowledge your fears. Acknowledge your fears of what is coming. Acknowledge your self-preservation dynamics. Fear is always something that is going to, I'm going to die, I'm going to cease to exist, or whatever, as we saw it in the first story with Eve and what she thought, I'm going to die if I eat from the tree of knowledge. So you need to acknowledge your death fear. You need to acknowledge your fear of losing. And you need to acknowledge your fear of change. And you need to acknowledge your fear of my not being able to handle this. And I talk about this in the Future Human Project course 1-4, and I also allude to it in the free material, and I also allude to it in my books, the different ways that you can balance out fear and emotional responses, because it is a dynamic system of oppositions. So everything is not about getting into indifferent levels. It is about acknowledging the one side of it, acknowledging the other side of it. Do what you need to learn to handle both sides of it. Understand that it's a scale of different forms of emotions that responds in different forms of chemical reactions. And then you learn to control these chemical reactions, either in meditation or in yoga or in running or mentalization or different dynamics or self-healing or whatever you need. You learn to handle that energy. And then you calm in the center point, where you then decide what you will do with these different forms of energy. So are you going to evaporate them and take out the patterns and whatever they are in your emotional field? Or are you going to try and upgrade them and see if you can develop them into something more cleverly? That's part of the emotional journey. So that is, I know this, and the correct emotional response. And then the implementation into the physical level. Always work in triune systems. Thought, feeling, physicality, idea, response to it, implementation, choice, consideration, action. So there are always three-fold responses to whatever's going on in you that goes with the three layers that you are composed of. So that would be my answer to, if you ask me a question, should I do this and that, whatever, figure it out yourself. What do you, with what I have given you now of knowledge, how are you going to implement that knowledge into an active choice making that leads to an active progression of your emotional field, that leads to an active development of your mental capacity into a scientific, innovative, entrepreneurial way of discerning everything and learning to make the right strategies, learning to find the right solutions, and learning to work experimental and scientific with whatever comes your way. That's the first basic step of what you need to do. And again, learn to work with all of your fear systems, look them in the eye, name the troll by the name, and deal with it. Get rid of this belief system. Go into psychotherapy if you need to do that, to get these fear systems under control. Fear is healthy when it tells you to run and you run. Fear is unhealthy when you use it to go into stress and you take out all sorts of natural, logical reasoning solutions out because you are in doubt or you stress or you get anxiety or you get afraid of this and that and whatever, build upon mental constructions and emotional fear systems that are connected to your defense mechanisms. That goes back to your childhood. And some of these fears are also from past lives. So some of the work also need to be some sort of regression, learning to see some of your past lives, where you have molecular fear that is built into your physical level. That's the last piece of the work, so to speak. But you need to have tools to work with your mental and emotional capacities. You have to have both the ability to do cognitive therapy that works with the schemata and the different mind forms that you have, thought forms. You need to have emotional pattern, discernment, ability to transform and use vision, what you call imagination, creative imagination. I also talk about this in my older books. I give exercises there. So there are plenty of tools out there with humans out there that are working pro and against whatever is coming in our future. Some of the therapies are on the one side of the fence, there's some of them on the other side, and you are to learn the difference. You are to spot them right away, which can actually trust and which cannot trust. And at some point, you will know you can trust absolutely nobody, and you can only work with yourself, and you can only do your own stuff, because people influence each other, people affect each other energetically, emotionally, mentally, physically. So there are also a certain point in your journey where you will understand that other people that are not doing this journey with you will actually not be particularly favorable for the work that you're trying to achieve. And then a period of time with self-containment and self-isolation, as we are already training now, might be what we will have to do from time to other in our society when certain energies are on a specific level that is not particularly healthy for us. It's not healthy to go outside, or it's not healthy to be around other people because stuff is going on. Well, then we will get the alarm running, and we must go indoors and self-contain and stay isolated for a period of time until these energies have subsided. That's going to be part of our future. So there are lessons to be learned, and you might as well, you can choose to be proactive or you can choose to be reactive. And I am clearly on the group of people that are proactive, and I am also reactive because I can't foresee everything. But what I can take control of, I do take control of. What I can't take control of, I don't take control of. I don't even try. There's certain things I can't control. I can't control the corona, but I can take control of how I respond to it. So that's what you can do. What you cannot take control of, that's global level. That's happening with beyond your influential sphere. But what you can take control of is how you respond to it, how you work with it, and how you develop yourself within the frame of reference that's been given to you. Do you respond with despair and using the whole scale of the negative 70s? Or are you actually choosing, this is a learning lesson I can use to create a balance point from where I can transform and transmute myself into a higher state of being, becoming more knowledgeable about myself, about my circumstances, and about what I've been put into? This is the line of thought you need to develop. This is the mastery of your emotional field you need to develop. And at the same time, you also need to learn your body, relearn your body. Most of you have no contact with your body. Most of you can't even feel your body. Most of you, I can feel every single cell of my body. I know, I can look at things in my body and I know what it's doing. I know the cellular structure. I know the energies that are going on. I can look into all of the five dimensions it's composed of. Whenever I have a pain, I work with that one. I feel what it is. I investigate what it is. I go through all five dimensions, figuring out where the root of the pain is and why it's there and why I have this crystallization going on that leads to pain. What do I need to do with it? I'm not sitting there, I'm going in scientifically, finding the root of the pain, the cause of the pain, and why is it there? What do I need to do with it? With every single thing in my life. If I have fear, where does it come from? Why do I have it? Where did it originate from? So what is the purpose of all five dimensions, all the fucking time? And sorry for being a little bit deterministic, a little bit strong in my energy here. So that is where you can take the warrior path into something productive. So you don't get victimized. Because one of the things a warrior do not get, that's victimized. Warrior is about strategy, triage, assessment, solutions, choices. This is what I want to do. So this is where, if I can take some of my warrior modalities with me and give it to you and say, this is what the path of the warrior is within the lower five fields of your existence, within the human realm, within this world as you know of it, that is what you can use it for here. I'm not here saying, giving you the sword of Michael and ask you to slay the dragons yet. I'm not doing that. That's in the fifth dimension and fourth dimension. but I'm still teaching you enough so that on the physical level, emotional level, and mental level, there you can use the warrior to work against everything that is working against you. And technically, the true warrior begins there. And the warrior on the three lower level will not become this huge, humongous fifth dimensional warrior in the future, but you will become a master of what you are. So that's kind of also a new perception and perspective of the warrior mentality in a little bit more productive way that is not necessarily opening up to the fifth dimension and inviting in all the dark forces, which you then have to fight with. But let's just keep it emotional, mental, and physical. Okay, so that's that strength I just gave you there. And it's not that you're driving yourself too hard so that you burn out. This is where you respect your limitations. This is where you listen to your body. This is where you listen to what you can do. If there are days when you can't do a damn thing, you just sit around the fire and relax and look up into the sky or out in the blue, whatever, and meditate and heal and take care of yourself and be self-nurturing and all these kind of things, because a warrior takes good care of his or her body. A warrior takes good care of his or her emotional field. A warrior takes good care of the mental field. We are focused on that everything we are must be as efficient as possible, must be as optimized as possible, must be as healthy and functional as possible, because our sole purpose is to complete a task. And what do we need to do to complete that task? That's the warrior mentality. That's the strength of the warrior. I train my body so that I can handle whatever energies come my way, so I have the physical strength to withhold whatever comes my way, so I will not succumb to pain, so I will not succumb to my mental thought forms. I am in control of my mind, so I know what I'm thinking, so I know it won't deplete my emotional field and drain my energies into the astral plane. I am in control of my emotions, so I can transform them into a higher version of what they are, so they can amplify my physical level, my molecular structure, so that my DNA will release the correct type of enzymes, so I will have a healthy body. I hope you understand this completely different way of approaching who and what you are. This does not mean that you are a control freak, that you control yourself into compulsive disorders, that you become obsessive, because these are unbalanced. It's kind of having the samurai mentality, the ancient warrior that mastered physicality, emotions, and mental things, that had the sword of clarity, that were able to do the moves of ki or chi, if you want to do it that way, so that strength came into the body, that were able to transform the energies of the body into a way so that if any type of physical activity were necessary, the body would respond in kindness and in caring and in, yes, I want to work with you. Yes, I want to do this. So this is when you do this whole kind of extreme control and strengthening kind of thing, it's you becoming the ultimate leader of everything you are. You become the ultimate warrior that is able to handle reality in peace and in war. That's the ultimate warrior mentality, knowing when to cut and knowing when to let go, knowing when to stand still and knowing when to run, knowing when to fight and knowing when to put down your sword, knowing when to be kind and knowing when to balance out whatever is coming your way with the right methods, with the right energy, and with the right knowledge. That would be my answer if you ask me, what am I to do? This is what you are to do. How you do it, how you achieve it, how you get there, that's part of my classes. I've given you all the best advices I can give. But if you want to go somewhere else, if you want to develop this in your own way, if you want to invent your own systems, do. That's part of the warrior path as well, because the warrior works alone, and that's why the what we call the dark ones are all individuals, because they are also warriors. But they have lost the sense of unity. They have lost the sense of the wholeness. They have lost the highest good of the many. They have lost the original purpose of why they're doing what they're doing. They are now doing it for brute survival. But we do this so that future races can coexist and continue to exist. We do this so that we prevent an unnecessary war. We do this for the highest good of the many. We do this so that others can follow in our path. We do this so that others can heal and prosper. We do this so that not everybody has to suffer. We do this to prevent the greater evil by ensuring that the highest good of the many will prevail. And we do this because we are brave enough to stand strong and be honorable and discern and use our knowledge and what the strength we have, not just as us being in the center of the circle and being the center of the universe, but we are being that as true leaders, as inspirers, as role models, as the ones that are willing to go first so that fewer has to suffer. That's the warrior. In a conceptualization that does not actually involve war. Thank you.